Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. We have a 3v3 match for you today, as we have an RTK versus SOTM clan battle from this clan war this past weekend. For RTK representing, we have Wicked Pirate leading the Vampire Coast. We have Majutsu leading the Wood Elf forces, and Lumiere is leading the Empire forces up against SOTM, who we have Grom Brindle on the Bretonian side, Predator leading the Tomb Kings, and Mercernik is leading the Lizardmen forces. So we will try and give a quick little rundown of what each army has brought today. So for some Empire forces, we do have 3 Demigriff Knights, which is very good against any of the Bretonian and kind of the Lizardmen large targets in this matchup. We also have some Waywatchers from the Wood Elf side, always a very strong pick, very strong missile unit. We also have some Glade Guard, with some nice poison damage incoming, and some Eternal Guard on the far right flank. For the bulk of the center formation is going to be the Vampire Coast, just zombie pirate deckhand mobs. For the front line, we are going to have bombers in the back behind them, which will do very well against any of the Tomb Kings infantry units that come, and any of the lighter armored of the Lizardmen side. And I suppose you can also expect maybe a few peasants, or that will do very well against them. We have some of the polearm variant protecting the Sunmaker that the Empire has brought for us today, as he has already started firing away. We have some crossbowmen in the rear to provide some aerial support, as well as some handgunners and a zombie pirate gunnery mob to protect the rear of the engagement, and just a couple more pole arms on the far flanks. The 3 lords for RTK are going to be a clay lord up on her eagle with arrows of Kurnos and prey of Anathrema. We also have Boris Todbringer for the Empire up on his griffin, and we have Noctilus up on his Necrofex Colossus. We have a Spellsinger of Life with Earthblood and Regrowth. As for the rest of the left flank of the RTK forces, we have a couple more Eternal Guard holding it down, and another poison source in the form of these Glade Guard. And that will wrap things up for the RTK forces. Now we swing on over to who they will be facing. So on the right flank of the SOTM forces, we have a couple of Ushapti kind of heading that right flank up for them. And then it's going to be pretty much a mix of Tomb Kings and Lizardmen forces from here on out. We are going to have some halberds on the far right flank to prevent any flanking maneuvers by any cavalry or large targets. But then otherwise it's going to be a mix of Saurus warriors and skeleton warriors with a few, I believe there's some Tomb Guard in here. There they are. But yeah, the front line is pretty much Saurus and Skeleton Warriors. The rear, or the secondary line for their forces, is going to be more elite. You're going to get those Tomb Guards, 3 of those, and then you're going to have the Battle Pilgrims in the back, one of which being the Holy Wardens of La Maison Tell. And we're going to have as well 2 Solar Bastillodon engines. And the far right flank is going to be far left flank is going to be 3 Pterodon Riders and the Bretonian cavalry forces. We're going to have some Knights of the Realm, Knights Errant, and Mounted Yeomen kind of vanguarded way up in front. And for the leadership department of these forces, we're going to have a Skink Priest of East with their summons. And I did forget about a Tomb Scorpion as well. But otherwise, for the Bretonians, they are bringing the Fey Enchantress, Gotrek. And we take a quick look at what the Fey has brought. So we do have Earthblood and Regrowth. And for the Lizardmen, we have Gorok. Take a quick look at what his kit is going to be bringing. And he is bringing the Shield of the Eons with a nice buff to his armor and Expert Charge Defense that was usually brought for that armor ability. The Rock of Itza, and of course, Cold-Blooded, as all Lizardmen do. Tomb Kings, actually, I do remember we have a few more units. The Tomb Kings are going to be bringing Arkhan the Black. He's going to be bringing Spirit Leech, the Libra Mortis, the Staff of Nagash, and the Tomb Blade of Arkhan. We also have another, the Champions of Quinnell's, the Questing Knights ROR on the far right flank. Some more Bretonian Cav, which will be expected from them. So that will wrap things up for the armies today, and let's get this show going. It is going to be a good one, one way or the other. As yes, the Hellstorm has fired in a couple rounds already. They got a few shots in onto the Sauros Warriors, but more are raining in, and we'll be seeing them connecting, doing a ton of damage to these Skeleton Warriors. I would assume you're going to see a lot of targets into either probably the Tomb King forces. They're going to be doing the most damage to them, especially the Elite Tomb Guard. But yes, Battle Pilgrim's getting clipped as well. More shots raining in. Noctilus getting his Arcane Conduit off, getting a nice little buff to his magic regen. And now we have some troops who have been discovered. These Demigryph Knights have kind of discovered, well, the Mounted Yeomen have discovered the Demigryph Knights, pretty much almost wavering right off the bat without really taking any damage. Three Demigryph Knights is quite a scary threat to be seen. Bastilled on engine, firing into Noctilus, shots just kind of nipping at his heels as some of the Clade Guard are firing into Arkhan as he baits out a few of their shots, as well as Noctilus's barrage. You will be probably switching over to the cavalry forces, but the Bastillodons, both of which are targeting Noctilus, and the Shade Wraith Gunners for the Vampire Coast are firing in, doing some very good work as well. But Gotrek and the Fey Enchantress have gotten into that frontline engagement. The Bombers will be firing their volley in any second as we see that volley and doing a ton of damage to those Skeleton Warriors, and more of the Sunmaker lining up shots against the Holy Wardens, while the Bastillodons continue to fire in, not really doing all that too much damage. Despite being a very effective against the undead, Noctilus seems to be weathering that assault fairly well. We have the Demigryph Knights pretty much screening out everything in the background, but it looks like we have some of the Glade Guard have been caught out, though they may have been used more as screen some of these Cav forces. But now here come the Demigryph Knights getting the engagement that they want. The Bretonians will get a nice little downhill charge, but the Demigryph Knights, this is their engagement. They want to be dealing with the Cav, and they have gotten their charge off. A nice counter charge through their own forces, but we do have a Feral Manticore and the Skink Chief, Skink Priest, chasing after the Glade Lord with one of their summons. Though the Tomb Scorpion, who did get into the backlines at least initially, is being chased off by Boris, and the Fey Enchantress has been just focused down by all of the ranged firepower of the Waywatchers and the Vampire Coast. So she is taking a lot of damage. The Sunmaker has already used up all of its ammo. We do have a couple of White Kings here. I don't necessarily know if they can assist the other factions, though I would imagine they can with their extra powder. Though we take a quick look, we see that the Demigryph Knights are pretty much mopping things up for the Bretonians. Their right flank is very secured, but the left flank is a little bit on the danger side, as the forces of the Tomb Kings with the Ushabti have gotten into the back line. These Pirate Zombie Governory mob is screening out for Noctilus as the charge of the Champions of Quinnell's have gotten in. The Fey Enchantress has gotten topped off by some healing, despite all of the firepower that was going her way. The Waywatchers are now focusing in on Arkhan. Arkhan taking quite a bit of damage, but he does get the Ushabti gets summoned in on top of these Waywatchers. Now the bounce power very much in the forces of RTK at the moment, as Arkhan taking so much focus fire from those Waywatchers is now very critically low, and that'll prove to be quite a danger to the forces of the Tomb Kings. The Skink Priest has been chased off, at least for the time being, though unfortunately for RTK, it was not able to chase him off completely. So even though he only has used one summon so far, he will be getting his second off as long as he doesn't get cooned out any longer. Arkhan starting to crumble on the net, Prave and Thrayma actually going down as well, as the Feral Manticore from the Empire gets on top of him. The Liber Mortis trying to save him, but it will be in vain as Arkhan does go down. Very early loss for the Tomb Kings and very critical as well, as that will be the leadership department for at least the Tomb King side. But we still have Gorok, and Fae Enchantress may also have succumbed to the focus fire. No, she is still here, but she is at her healing cap already, so that just proves to how much healing is going down her way. Tomb Scorpion crumbling as well, as I believe Boris and the surrounding fire has gotten really on top of them. Shadewraith Gunners being pressured in by that Ushabti summons. But otherwise, the Demigryph Knights are being really cleaning up forces for the mobility department. And if we take a look, we do have some Waywatchers in the rear, as the Crossbowmen have also returned. Some Ushabti trying to help shut them down. Another Feral Manticore summons coming in for the Empire. That will be their second, trying to help assist the Glade Lord to chase off these Pterodon Riders. But we have the Zombie Pirate Gunnery Mob in the back, which will provide some nice, pretty much anti-aircraft fire. As actually the Fae Enchantress taking a lot of damage from the Feral Manticore, though Gotrek trying to get on top of Count Noctilus as the Demigryph Knights continue to cycle through that engagement, with the Solar Basilidon still firing in on all fronts. Ushabti taking a lot of firepower from these Zombie Pirate Gunnery mobs. We also have some Wild Riders who I did miss on the earlier side of those engagements, but otherwise the Bretonian mobility has pretty much been shut down for the most part, and the Fae Enchantress is down from what I can tell. That is actually Boris right there. Boris is engaging with Gotrek, and here is the Fae Enchantress. She is routing right now. She should be able to come back if there isn't anything that can pressure her, though there is plenty of mobility on the RTK side of things. They have two Flying Lords and plenty of mobility left, so I do not expect to see her around for too long. We do have the Sunmaker, who has gotten, it looks like, a little bit of ammo left. Might be able to get back onto their troop or onto their artillery pieces, but we shall see. The Bastillodons continuing to use up pretty much all of their ammo so far, as Boris is trying to screen out some of these Tomb Guard and Battle Pilgrims from putting pressure onto their back line. Glade Lord pushing off that Fae Enchantress. A few shots in the back should be able to finish her for good, and at this point I do not expect to see her anymore. We have a Flock of Doom clipping a couple, actually like three units of the Saurus Warriors and Tomb Guard, and the Tomb Guards with Halberds as well. Now if we take a look at this center engagement, we have Boris holding off against Gotrek as shots are raining in from at least one Waywatcher unit. So that will be doing some fairly decent damage. Gotrek still has a bit of healing, but with the introduction of Gorok, Boris is probably going to want to be pulling out, save his health for later. Though, surprise, surprise, we do have the Fae Enchantress has come back, at least for the time being. She is routing, and once again, though, so that is going to be unfortunate for them. And there down, she drops a Wraithstorm, dropping down onto Gorok, also clipping Gotrek a little bit, as well as Boris Todbringer has been able to escape, at least for the time being. The Wood Elves have, at least for the time being, been able to save Count Noctilus from the pressure that he was seeing. Though we do have now the Bastillodons starting to come into the melee engagement, and they are both at full health, and that is going to be quite something for RTK to be able to deal with. They still have quite a bit of firepower left. The Waywatchers have a decent amount of ammo, and you still have the Gunnery Whites, who should be able to do some nice damage, and Boris, who is an anti-large combatant, so he should be able to do some good work against those Solar Bastillodons. Though we do have the Amber Wizard, who has used up pretty much all of his uses. Though we do have the Demigryph Knights coming in, and this is going to be their engagement that they want. Not a whole lot of models left. And I believe at about this time, we did have one of our RTK members drop. Lumiere commanding the Empire did drop from this match, unfortunately. I think it was a little while ago. So the AI has taken control of his troops for the time being. Right now the balance of power is very much in RTK's favor. We have Waywatchers, which pretty much have half ammo left, and they still are sitting at about 26 models. It's quite a bit of firepower heading their way. Noctilus kind of keeping his distance from Gorok and the Saurus Warriors, though we have Gotrek is in combat with Boris, and that is where Gotrek does want to be engaging against those large targets. Boris is would mostly like to be up against the Bastillodon and to keep Gotrek away from there, as he does go down from the damage that Gotrek was dealing out. Some Pterodons still providing some aerial support, though the Gunnery White able to knock down at least one of those models, as the Glade Lord is going to be able to chase them away. Another shot at that one coming in from the Glade Lord, able to down another model, shattering what is left for the Pterodon Riders. Now, if we take a little swing on back to get a little glimpse of the battle, we have a Gunnery White Noctilus, and then the Wood Elves are all that remains. The AI has not really done any favors for RTK, pretty much suiciding what is left of their units, and it is just going to be the Wood Elves and the Vampire Coast left against these Bastillodons and some very haggard infantry units from the Lizardmen and Tomb Kings, with just a couple units of Battle Pilgrims mix into the fight. Glade Lord coming in, trying to goon out Gorok, as he is a little isolated this time, getting a nice charge in and pulling out before Gorok can do anything in return. Now we have the Bastillodons, who do pretty much constant poison damage to targets they are chasing. These arrows that you see coming off of them all do poison damage, so that will be slowing all of these units, slowing them down, so they aren't going to be able to kite as effectively. Gotrek is exceptionally low. He is at his healing cap by the looks of things, and if we take a look, he is at 627 health. More shots raining in from these Waywatchers, but Gotrek is nipping at the heels of Count Noctilus. And Noctilus is going to want to try and pull out, but he is pretty much surrounded by all of the enemy forces in this situation. Once again, the Glade Lord coming into Gorok, who is continuing to push a little, probably too far ahead of the rest of his units. But the Saurus Warriors are going to be assist him at least a little bit, though it looks like Gorok will be falling to some fire from these Waywatchers. And down he goes. Bastillodon working to get rid of the last of the healing for the RTK forces. Some shots raining in, though for the time being looks like he's trying to chase down these Waywatchers. But this Bastillodon is hot on the tail of Count Noctilus. This is actually a regrowth going down onto Noctilus, trying to get some of that vigor and healing back, and that should be able to top him off, at least in terms of his healing cap. A lot of healing coming his way, and he should be able to pull out with the assistance of the Glade Lord. But the Saurus Warriors are chasing after the Spellsinger at this point, where they are wavering. The Spellsinger could potentially rout them off if she turns around and gets a few shots in the rear. Well, I think the Glade Lord is going to be trying to do that, as a nice shot from Noctilus does free up that Spellsinger, at least for now, though Gotrek is chasing down Noctilus, and the poison from these two Bastillodons is going to allow these units to at least stay very close, if not to outright catch Noctilus in the end. We'll see if this Glade Lord is able to kind of peel things off, at least temporarily, as she does get a nice Alpha Strike onto Gotrek, finally finishing him off, as the balance power is starting to shift a bit more into the favor of SOTM. Now, at this point, we do have just two Bastillodons as pretty much the bulk and almost the sole units remaining for the combined forces of the Lizardmen, Bretonnia, and Tomb Kings. We have some very isolated units of Saurus Warriors and Battle Pilgrims, as well as one more unit of Tomb Guard, though the fire from the Waywatchers should be able to clean things up, and the Glade Lord cycling in should allow them to finally shatter those units. But it looks like Noctilus is in a bit of a predicament right now, surrounded by the Saurus Warriors, who he does manage to rout. But the Bastillodon is still doing constant damage to him in the form of their missile fire. Might just be a little too much, as he is crumbling, and the Glade Lord right now is a little too far away to assist in that matter. More shots continuing to rain in as we take a look at what is left for these Waywatchers to deal with. A final shot, I think, raining in into these Tomb Guard who are crumbling as well. Glade Lord finishing them off. I think all she has to do now is chase off these Battle Pilgrims, make sure that they are shattered fully and completely. But down goes Noctilus, losing a leg and falling into the ground as the continual fire from these Bastillodons was able to do enough damage to bring him down. Now, the Waywatchers, I do believe, have used up the last of their ammo, so it is just going to be down to the Glade Lord against these two Bastillodons. We do have some spears coming in, but they are wavering right now, and they probably won't even get close to these Bastillodons to assist in that battle. Balance of power now going the other way, as the Spellsinger is being taken out of the fight. So no healing left for the Glade Lord. Glade Lord, seeing that these Battle Pilgrims have returned, swooping in, trying to finish them off as she does finally shatter them. And now it is just going to be the Glade Lord, three units of Waywatchers without any ammo left to deal with two Bastillodons. So at this point, really needs to be, as long as these Bastillodons stay together, I believe they shouldn't have any problem with dealing with what is left. Yeah, no, pretty much the Wood Elves are regrouping what forces they have, and the Glade Lord trying to get the optimal engagement in this case. Now they are kind of fanning out a little bit, trying to draw the attention of these Bastillodons away from pretty much their key target, which will be the Glade Lord, the deciding factor in this final stage of the battle. The Bastillodons almost separate out, but these two Waywatchers do converge, looking to potentially get a final surround off onto this Bastillodon engine as the Glade Lord gets a nice rear charge in. Though now both Bastillodons do focus on the same target, as all of the Waywatchers are terrified from these two Bastillodons, so these late game terror being a massive threat as the Glade Lord finally routs, and the Sons of the Mountain will claim a victory in this final 3v3. Now, of course, you have to take this with a little bit of grain of salt, as Lumiere, controlling the Empire forces, did get dropped from this battle, and those Demigryph Knights and Boris under the proper leadership would have been a massive advantage in that late game. But even with that, it was such a great game with the Sons of Mountain able to pull things back. And yeah, it was such a good match. These Bastillodons really proving that late game terror is just such a dangerous threat in any matchup. But that will wrap things up for us today. I hope you guys enjoyed this 3v3 matchup. I know it is quite a bit different scale than what we are traditionally doing on this channel, but yeah, it was a fantastic match, and I hope you all enjoyed. And as always, have a good one.